Hello everyone, welcome you all in this session. Myself, Assistant Professor Ripra Gupta from LJ School of Law. So today we'll discuss on the subject of Competition Act, and we're going to discuss on the topic of anti-competitive agreements. So as we discussed earlier that in Competition Act they have discussed about certain anti-competitive agreements that are, if they are prevail in the market, then they will have a punishment for the said agreements. So we'll discuss in the general sense today what are these agreements, then in later on we'll discuss these agreements in very detail. So we'll see the section 3 which defines this agreement. So section 3 sub clause 1 of the act defines in a very general way and a very broad sense that certain kind of agreements are prohibits in the Competition Act, and that includes the production, supply, distribution, storage, acquisition, control of goods or provision of services. You can see here that very broad range of agreements discussed over here in section 3 of the Competition Act. It includes supply of goods, production of goods, manufacturing of goods, even if the services and supplying of the services all will come under the anti-competitive. If you are making such an agreement which are affect to this this agreement linked to supply or manufacturing, and you are making agreement related to that, then this may be declared as anti-competitive agreement and you may have to face penalties for this. This section says that this agreement, it is apply, production and manufacturing and services, if that agreements have adverse impact on the competition of India, then it's said to have an appreciable adverse effect. So that means they have to prove that your agreements have an appreciable adverse effect on the competition, then it has some penalties or fine on that agreement, or they may declare as a void agreements. So this section 3 sub clause 1 is very wide and broad in that sense. It includes so much agreements in there, one umbrella which includes supply, manufacturing, services and everything, but that should have an appreciable adverse effect on the competition in India. So even the foreign company who is doing manufacturing or supplying goods in India, if that has an impact on the competition in India, then that will come under the purview of Competition Act. Now section 3 sub clause 2 talks about the void agreement. It says that whatever the agreements defines 3 sub clause 1 that we have already discussed just earlier, that supply of goods, the manufacturing of goods, this agreement is to be declared void by the Competition Commission of India. That is defined in section 3 sub clause 2. Now section 3 sub clause 3 precisely talks about particular agreement that we can say as a horizontal agreement. It specifies certain agreements may be entered into practice by the similar enterprises in the same identical enterprises. For example, all the cement companies came together and make an agreement, fix the prices, fix the supplies, then it become a horizontal agreement. So if we identical companies or enterprises make an agreement for the supply, manufacturing, production of the goods or the services of the goods, then become a horizontal agreement, and this kind of agreements are per se void. So usually anti-competitive agreements include certain things like price fixing, that where they fix the price, resale price maintenance, they maintain the price in the resale market, then allocation among suppliers, how to supply the goods in the suppliers, then reducing the supply. These are the agreements that the enterprises make themselves so they can cut down the competition in the market. So these are the examples of anti-competitive agreements. Section 3 sub clause 4 talks about vertical agreements. Section 3 sub clause 3 talks about horizontal agreement, and this about vertical agreements. Horizontal agreements are per se void, and vertical agreements are not per se void. There you have to prove it. Now what is vertical agreements? Here you are agreeing with the in a chronological, first example with the manufacturing, then the production, then the suppliers, they are contracted with it between them, that is called vertical agreements. Here manufacturer will contract with the suppliers, supplier will contract with the resale parties. Here they make an agreement which may have impact on the impact on the competition. So here you can see examples, that manufacturer is stipulating that a dealer should not sell the goods in certain point of money. For example, if I am making contract that you should not sell my goods below this price, or you should sell these goods on that price only. So these are the contract in the vertical agreements which have impact on the competition and where the suppliers and the manufacturing make the contracts between them. So these are termed as a vertical agreements, but they are not per se void like a horizontal agreement. Here you have to prove that this agreement has appreciable adverse impact on the competition, and then after that can be declared as a void, or they may can impose fine on such agreements. Now last section 3 sub clause 5 of the anti-competitive agreement talks about the exception with the agreements. Here they talk about the rights of the IP holder. See, if I'm a IP holder like a patent, copyright or trademark, then I have exclusive right on my goods, to whom I want to supply, on what price I want to supply, because I have a IPR rights on my product or my goods or anything which I have my IPR rights. So here the exception with the IPR holders, that they can fix the price of their goods, they can supply, they can restrict the supply. So these, they have the exception in the anti-competitive agreements. They can make agreements because they don't have any kind of competition in the market. So we have discussed a general idea about anti-competitive agreements which are there in Competition Act. We'll see them in detail by my later lectures, but these are the general provision which has been described in the new Competition Act, which says that these agreements are have an appreciable adverse effect on the competition, then they will be declared as a per se void, or they need to prove that they are not have an appreciable adverse effect on the market. So this Competition Market Competition Act encourages the competition, but the competition should not be make such an agreement which have an adverse effect on the competition. And it also gives right to the IPR holder who have the rights on IPR. They are exception from these agreements. So it is all about the agreements defined in Competition Act. Thank you.